My dear husband.
My sweet wife.
My best friend.
The love of my life. Peggy, let me use this time to tell you that all of our friends and family, just how wonderful it is to have them complete. I'm sorry, that we have completed the 27 years and we have had great life. You are the reason that I do everything, Peggy. Everything that I do is for you. What a blessing I was given when I was given you to share my life with him. I wouldn't trade it for any love story. Anybody. But this is going to be a little difficult since I'm my illness. No? Okay. No. Then it's your turn. It's your turn.
You are my heart and soul, my life, my reason to live. My love is my greatest gift to give, and I give it to you today and forever. We have enjoyed 27 years together, laughing, learning, loving, and working our tails off just to survive. It never seemed to matter what blocked our path together. We stood. You took me by the hand, and I felt your strength flow through me. Always looking forward, never backwards, no regrets. We won. We never surrendered. Always winners. When the dust settled, there we stood, hand in hand, heart to heart, and we loved until the end. The vow that I make you today, in front of all that are present, is to love, honor, cherish you, as long as we both shall live, even after death do us part. I know together we will never surrender. My love, my heart, my soul will be yours for eternity. God has joined us once in Las Vegas, second time today, with our family and friends, and the next time we'll be in the beautiful garden, where we will be joined again, hand in hand, heart to heart, and forever madly in love with each other. I love you, my precious wife.
I love you.
They say you win. Hit again. 'Cause I love you still. Maybe this can be the end. Just like fog in the car. Stop. looking at you, kid. Missing all the things we did. We can find it once again.
Just like the game.
After everybody's gonna fall off of their feet.
Can I get a Wayne's ring? Wayne, we use a ring in marriage as a symbol of eternity, symbol of never-ending love. And you guys already understand that. Today, Peggy, as you place this upon his finger, it is a symbol once again of a love that has been renewed over and over and over again throughout the years. It is a gift from God to fall in love with one another each and every day throughout your life. And very few marriages do that. And so all of us here, we thank you for that example. Hey, if you'll place this upon his... I don't know if I can get it out, but you did
now. Stuck in there good.
Place that upon his finger and repeat after me. This ring I give you.
This ring I give you.
As a symbol of my love promised.
As a symbol of my love promised.
And my love forever.
And my love forever.
Can I have Peggy's ring? Peggy, also, as we look at your ring, and you guys have chosen matching rings to symbolize one heart and unity, completely together. And I want to remind you that we are eternal beings, and no matter what happens, as you said in your vows, you are one. You're one in flesh, you're one in spirit. God has put you together, and you always will be. And as you wear this ring, always remember that. Wayne, if you'll place this upon Peggy's finger and repeat after me. This ring I give you.
This ring I give you.
As a symbol of my love promised.
As a symbol of my love promised.
And my love forever.
And my love forever. I love you.
At this time, Peggy is going to give rings to her children and grandchildren.
Now our children.
Now our children and grandchildren will join us in our promising commitment to each other to always be our family, united by love.
Stand by me.
I would tell you here today and everybody that the whole world's looking for love. And God has designed us, where that's what we need, what we crave. But love is hard, as we said earlier. And one of the most difficult things about love is true love is sacrifice. Scripture says that greater love has no man but to give up his life for his friend. And we saw that in Jesus Christ as he gave up his life for us. And so until you have unbelievable circumstances, true love can never be seen. Because true love is unconditional. True love is something only that can be seen when the other person can return it. When the other person is struggling, the other person is having a difficult time. And so even though the whole world is looking for love, we rarely see it. We rarely see it. Today, as we come here together, we understand everything that you're going through and that you've been through, and you're loving one another unconditionally. It's true love. And I would say that there are many people who go through this and it tears them apart, tears their family apart, tears their marriage apart. I've sat in rooms with people going through the same thing that you're going through, and it's completely destruction. And yet what you guys have done is use this time to draw together. And it is something that many people will never see other than your example today. And I believe that God chooses people sometimes that he knows will not lose faith, that will hold on, that will grow stronger spiritually, mentally, emotionally, even as the physical part becomes taxing. And I believe that you are a gift from God, that you're able to love one another, continue to love God. This that you are doing today is for you, but it's also for everybody else here. And it's powerful. And so I want to commend you for, once again, being selfless and loving. Marriage between a man and woman is intended to be an earthly portrait of a heavenly scene. There's nothing greater than God can give us than a picture of what true love really is. And you have allowed the Lord to use you today to give us all that gift, that we shall see what real love is. He has to give us human examples of what spiritually we can't always see. So today, as you come together again to renew your vows, renew your love, you do it before generations, so that there is a gift that will last. And as our world continues to go the way that it is and love becomes more difficult, children and grandchildren will remember this day when they're going through the valleys, and they'll say, but I remember when mom and dad, grandma and grandpa, whatever they call you, they held on through it all. And you've come here today to say, through it all, I still love you. I'm still here. And I'm not going anywhere. And I commend you for that.
Well, thank you.
And now by the power vested in me by the state of Texas and the Lord God Almighty, I do pronounce you again, husband and wife, groom and bride, best friends forever and ever. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Wait, normally I would say you may kiss your bride, but you've already kissed her about 12 times. So let's do it one more time. There you go.
Love you. Love you. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you all so much. So this is a great time.
Yeah.
This is our happy place. Okay.
Ready?
Are we ready?